Miles to go, everybody. Welcome to Sharpen Up Online Classes. Today, we will study Class 6 Geography, Chapter Number 2, Globe, Latitudes and Longitudes. The chapter has numerous terms. We will begin with Term 1, that is Geoid. Geoid. Geoid means the shape of our Earth. The shape of our planet Earth is geoid. And geoid means flattened, slightly flattened at the poles and bulging in the middle. Slightly flattened at the poles, that is North Pole and South Pole, and slightly bulged in the middle. Now we will study about globe. Globe is a true model or miniature of the Earth. Miniature of the Earth. The countries, continents and oceans are shown on the globe in their correct sizes. Also, we must know about the axis, a line, an imaginary line that passes through North Pole and South Pole is known as the axis of the Earth. Now, the term equator, you must have heard of it a lot. Equator. Well, equator is an imaginary line running on the globe, dividing it into two equal parts. An imaginary line running on the globe, dividing it into two equal parts. The northern half is known as northern hemisphere and southern part is known as southern hemisphere. They are both equal halves. So, therefore, we can say that equator is an imaginary circular line and also an important reference point to locate places on Earth. Another term is parallels of latitudes. Parallels of latitudes. All parallel circles from the equator up to the poles are known as parallels of latitudes. Now, how do we measure latitudes? Well, latitudes are measured in degrees. An equator is a 0 degree latitude. Now, north latitudes and south latitudes. Well, all latitudes north of the equator are known as north latitudes. And all latitudes south of the equator are known as south latitudes. Now let us learn about important parallels of latitude. Important parallels of latitude. I am sure you must have heard about them. Number one is Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree north in the northern hemisphere. And Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degree south in the southern hemisphere. Similarly, Arctic Circle, 66.5 degree north in northern hemisphere. And Antarctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree south in the southern hemisphere. So remember, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle, Arctic Circle. Arctic Circle in northern hemisphere, Antarctic Circle in southern hemisphere. Heat zones of the world. There are 3 heat zones of the world. Number 1, torrid zone. Number 2, temperate zone. Number 3, frigid zone. Torrid zone. Area between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Midday sun is exactly overhead at least once a year on all latitudes in between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. This area therefore receives maximum heat and is called torrid zone. Number 2, temperate zone. Midday sun never shines overhead on any latitude beyond Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. The angle of sun's rays goes on decreasing towards the poles. As such, the areas bounded by Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle in the northern hemisphere and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle in the southern hemisphere have moderate temperatures and are therefore called temperate zones of the world. Number 3, frigid zones. Areas bounded by Arctic Circle and North Pole in the northern hemisphere and Antarctic Circle and South Pole in the southern hemisphere are very cold. It is because the sun does not rise much above the horizon. The sun's rays are always slanting. Therefore, they are called frigid zones. Now let's learn about Prime Meridian. The meridian which passes through Greenwich, which is a place, Greenwich, where British Royal Observatory is located, is known as Prime Meridian. Let me repeat. A meridian which passes through Greenwich, where British Royal Observatory is located, is known as Prime Meridian. Its value is 0 degree longitude and from it we count 180 degree eastwards as well as 180 degree westwards. The Prime Meridian divides the Earth into two equal halves, Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. The longitude of a place is followed by E for eastward and W for westward. It is, however, very interesting to note that 180 degree east and 180 degree west meridians are on the same line. Another topic, meridians of longitude. Meridians of longitude. Lines of reference running from North Pole to South Pole are called meridians of longitude. Distances between them are measured in degrees of longitudes. Each degree is further divided into minutes and minutes into seconds. Now let's learn about Indian Standard Time, IST, Indian Standard Time. Well, to learn about Indian Standard Time, we must learn about Standard Meridian. A meridian at 82.5 degree east is known as Standard Meridian. And local time on this meridian is taken as Standard Time for all country, which is known as Indian Standard Time. Now let us learn some fun facts about Prime Meridian and Earth. Prime Meridian, when sun is at the highest point, all the places on Prime Meridian will have midday or noon. Also to remember, Earth rotates from west to east. This means that all the places east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time and all the places on the west will be behind it.